Now, checking out the performance of the characteristics, let me tell you what are the major concerns related to this the performance characteristics. I'm doing it for both the cases. For reflex klystron, we'll check out for reflex klystron the performance characteristics. So please go through with this. It's been a small differentiation. You can easily remember. If you have 1 or 2 minutes, if you could able to spend on this, you can easily remember. Okay, the first related to the reflex klystron, the performance characteristics we are about to discuss. And for that, the first is in a frequency range. What is the frequency range of this particular tube which can be operated? So that is being taken as from 4 gigahertz to 200 gigahertz. So it can be operated up to a frequency range of from 4 to 200 gigahertz. And second one, the output power, the maximum output power it can able to provide. And that is being given as 1 milliwatts to 2.5 watts. It depends upon the type of operation and when we given an input power supply. So accordingly, the output power which has been resulted, it has been given by as within this particular range. Then we have the theoretical efficiency. Theoretical efficiency which is been given. What is the efficiency and theoretical efficiency? Just now we have derived an expression for this. Please let me know from your side, what is the theoretical efficiency? I'm waiting for your response only. You can unmute and say, you can put it in the chat box. Yes, and I'm getting it. Others also, I want from others also. If you, they are responding, just make it fast, Andy. Ascent, fine. Good. Good, and thank you. So that's what? The 22.78, which we have got it as 22.78 is the efficiency which is being required. Just now we have checked out. And we have some practical frequency and practical efficiency. So practical efficiency, which is being obtained, which we have working out. So that's what the reflex klystron, which we are using in the laboratory and which it is being performed in the experiment. So by tomorrow and possible, because I told that there was a problem during the playing of videos of the directional coupler experiment. I'm sorry for that. The bandwidth which has been not sufficient, and I'll be sharing you separate videos because each and every, it is a 13 minutes video, but it has been occupying of 1.9 GB. okay, so such enough very high bandwidth it has been consuming, so that I'll be trying to separately I'll be sending it to your mails. Okay, so that from the mails you can check out the videos 1, 2, 3 accordingly you can work out and you can write in the records. Okay, and we'll check for that, and sorry for that, and I'll be sharing it at the earliest. And here the practical efficiency is from 10% to 20%. That is the efficiency which we get practically when we work out in the lab, in the laboratory. Then we have some tuning range, to what extent we can tune this particular frequency range. Okay, so tuning range of this particular tube, it is being given as from 5 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. You can tune to require for a particular value if you want enough maximum efficiency, or the for maximum application, for any of the applications, we can tune the frequency to this particular range. Okay. So then apart from that, we have some applications. The applications it has been given related to the reflex klystron, around 2 to 3 applications, and even more can be given here. The applications here can be given as in the case of receiver side. Okay, so in radar receivers, it is being used in radar receivers where it can able to absorb the signals returning back from the targets. Okay, so in the second case, it can be used in local oscillators. It can be used in local oscillators, and it can also be used as now the microwave generators. We have different microwave generators, which where it can be used as a source. Okay, it can be used as a source in microwave generators because it has been providing very high powers, output powers. Okay, and the frequency range of operation is also more. So that will be making use as a source. So that was a reflex crystalline source which we have using in the laboratory only. Okay, and with this, the another application we can say that it can be used as in parametric amplifiers. Okay, it can be used in parametric amplifiers as in of local oscillators. So these are the few applications which has been listed out. Now, coming to the case of two cavity. What are the differences we have in their performance characteristics? We'll check out now in a single paper. That is a two cavity klystron amplifier, the performance characteristics. Okay, so let us check the characteristics, whatever we have worked out. And for that, the performance characteristics, we have the frequency range. The frequency range which is being provided, it will be of lesser than that of the reflex klystron. So here it has been in terms starts from megahertz, that is from 250 megahertz to it will be operated up to 100 gigahertz. Whereas in case of the reflex klystron, it is being given up to 200. It supports up to 200. Okay. And the second characteristics, it can be given as the output power. So the output power it can provide as the 10 kilowatts to 500 kilowatts. So this is the maximum output power it can able to provide. Okay. And coming to the gain of this particular two cavity klystron amplifier, it has been given as 15 dB to around 70 dB of the gain it can able to provide. And the next we have the theoretical efficiency. Can anyone could able to give the efficiency of two cavity and it? Anyone of you can remember the efficiency of two cavity klystron amplifier? Yes, Sunday. Any others? As much as possible, if you get an if you could able to give the response, it will be very happy for from my side, because the people are following and listening the classes properly, and so that I'll be very happy that we have some interactive session, not one side communication. Okay, it should not be like enough what do we call like a radio or TV, just they will be playing and we are checking out, but we cannot respond. It should not be like that. At least it should be like in a walkie talkie and just traffic police, they will be holding it, na walkie talkie. Once I ask the question, then the response, it should be from your side. So there is one way communication from both the sides. Once I ask a question and I'll be stopping it and you have to reply for that. So that is enough one way communication using the walkie talkie, something like that. Okay, finally, now the efficiency which is being worked out as in a 58.2%. Okay, and this is the performance characteristics related to the two cavity. Now the applications which is being given as the applications of two cavity klystron amplifier, almost similar. We get the output power, it has been provided. The power output, which is being given in a different ways, we can make use of this output power, which is given by this particular tube. And it can be used at the transmitter section. You can able to get the difference here. In the case of reflex klystron, all it has been used in the case of receivers. But the two cavity, it can be used at, because it has enough high power. You can see here, the power is being from 10 kilowatts to 500 kilowatts, but whereas power here has been 1 milliwatts to 2.5 milliwatts, very less power. Okay, so it is being preferred for receiver case, and whereas the two cavity is being preferred for the transmit case, very high power is being obtained, so that more power is being required for transmitters. So that at UHF transmitters. Okay, it can be used at UHF transmitters. So it can be used for satellite communications. So it can be preferred at satellite communications, and it can be used as a, in case of radar transmitters. Radar receivers, we have preferred a reflex klystron, but for transmitters, we'll be making use of two cavity klystron amplifiers. And it can also be used as in the power oscillators, as we have made use in the case of reflex klystron, as power oscillators also it can be used. So these are a few the applications of both the cases, okay, in the reflex klystron and in the case of two cavity klystron amplifier. So these are the today's topic which I wanted to discuss to you, and that has been done with more clarity from my side, I can expect. And that's what 48 finally good, they have the same strength which was being expected in the previous class, the same case can be done, but it should be more than 50 and I have seen the case where the few staffs, those who are handling in the last semester, they have told me that the strength will not go beyond 50. But that's what the same I'm able to see the class work related to the TR2, which would able to provide the same strength less than 50 always only. But very less times I could able to see more than 50. But you are keeping your record as the same, not to go the strength beyond 50. Why the record it has to be maintained, and I don't know.